Previously, I gave the shiurim here about Torah mitzvot atluyot ba'aretz. That's our specialty in our institute, Machon HaTorah Be'aretz. Because today is Erev Chanukah, we thought that we'll do something about Chanukah. And I want to start with a very easy question. Why is Chanukah tonight? Meaning, why is Chanukah on the 25th of Kislev for 8 days? So we know the sort of Midrash that Chanukah is Chanu Kafhei, they camp Chanaya and Kafhei 25 of Kislev. And we all know, can you see now the Mekorot? Yes, can you see what I'm sharing?
Yes.
Yes, good, thank you. Okay, so we know the famous Gemara in Shabbat. My Chanukah, what is Chanukah? 25 of Kislev, we have 8 days, we can't do Hesped. When the Greeks entered the Heichal Bet HaMikdash, they defiled the cruses of oil there. Later, when the Hashmonaim won the war, they looked for the cruses of oil in the Heichal with the signature of Kohen Gadol. They found only one such cruz, they lit it, and it lasted for 8 days. That was the miracle. The following year, they officially commemorated those days as days of praise and thanks to God, very famous Gemara and Shabbat. So what do you mean, why Chanukah is in 25 of Kislev? Yehuda HaMaccabi and his people came into Beit HaMikdash on 25 of Kislev, and that was the day they lit the menorah in Beit HaMikdash. And the miracle was for 8 days because there was enough for 8 days until they could bring other oil from a different source, probably from the Nachalat Asher, and it took 8 days, so the miracle was 8 days. So the question can sound funny, but still I think there is a question. Second question is about the title that I gave. Is Chanukah truly a rabbinic holiday? We know that Chanukah and Purim are chagim mideRabbanan, from our sages. They're not asur in asiyat melacha, one can work. In Kriyat HaTorah that we read, we have only three people going up to the Torah, three olim, just like other weekdays, and not four like Rosh Chodesh, and not four like Chol HaMoed. And we know that Chanukah was after the Bible was finished, about 200 years, according to Chazal, after the end of the last story in the Bible, the stories of Ezra and Nehemiah probably, and more than 200 years afterwards was the story of Chanukah. So of course Chanukah is Chag Midrabanan, can't be Chag from the Torah because it's much, much after the Bible. Even in Megillat Esther, there was a question because Megillat Esther is basically rabbinic, Chag Midrabanan, even though it is written in the Bible. But the Gemara tells us there were discussions about it. The Gemara in Yoma, Esther is compared to the dawn, the Shachar, because Esther represents the end of the age of the miracles for the Jewish people. Sof Kol HaNisim. Esther is the last miracle, just like the dawn signals the end of the light. And then the Gemara asks, what about Chanukah? Chanukah as well was a miracle to Am Yisrael. And then the Gemara answers, Nitana lichtov ka'amrina. Meaning Chanukah wasn't written in the Bible. It was a miracle for Am Yisrael. But it wasn't written in the Bible, and Esther was. The Gemara in Megillah tells us that even Esther, Megillat Esther and Purim, it wasn't so simple. The Gemara says, Esther wrote and asked the Chachamim, Kva'uni ledorot, meaning create a new holidays for the Jews that we will celebrate from now on. Then they send her, Kim'at me'oreret alenu levin ha'umot. This will arouse the jealousy of the nation. So she said, but I'm already mentioned in Divrei Hayamim of Madai Uparas. And then they didn't want, and then she said, write a score for future generations. There was discussion. And then they found the Mikra Ketuba Torah. They found the hint in the Torah itself for Purim, for Megillat Esther. And then they somehow allowed the story of Esther to be written in the Bible. So Esther went in. But Chanukah did not. If it's true that Chanukah is 100% Achad Midi Rabbanan, how is the next Mishnah in Bikurim can be written? The Mishnah says, Mishnah Bikurim 1:6, Me'atzeret ve'ad Achad, Mevi ve'kore, from Shavuot to Sukkot, one brings and says, recites. We're talking about Bikurim. One brings Bikurim to Beit HaMikdash. And he says the Mikra Bikurim. Mikra Bikurim, these are the psukim in Parashat Ki Tavot that most people, when they bring Bikurim, they say them. We know the psukim today, mainly from Agadah Shel Pesach. Arami Oved Aviv, Vayarim Mitzrayimah, Vayagor Sham, Miten Yad, etc., etc. Vayareh Otanu HaMitzrim, Vayanudu, Vayitu Alenu Amada Kasha. That's Mikra Bikurim. So the Mishnah Bikurim says that there are people or times or situations you bring the Bikurim, but you don't say Mikra Bikurim. It's two different mitzvot in Sefer HaChinuch. Bringing Bikurim and saying the Mikra Bikurim. So from Atzeret ve'ad Achag, from Shavuot to Sukkot, you bring and read. Min Achag ve'ad Chanukah, from Sukkot and Chanukah, machloket. Tana Kama says, mevi ve'kore, you bring but you don't recite. Rabbi Yehuda ben Beterah says, you bring and recite. Meaning there's a machloket between Rabbi Yehuda and Tana Kama. Do you say Mikra Bikurim on this time, exactly our time now, between Chag Sukkot and Chanukah? But everybody agree you can bring Bikurim. What happens after Chanukah? Doesn't say, but it's clear. What do you mean? After Chanukah, you can't bring anymore. So Bikurim you can bring only till Chanukah, and not afterwards. Now, this halakha is very strange, because Mikra Bikurim is a mitzvah from the Torah. Mikra Bikurim is a mitzvah from the Torah. How does a mitzvah from the Torah depend on a time, on a holiday, that is Midrabanan? More than that, we know that Chanukah was established only about 200 years after the beginning of the Second Temple. What happened before? What happened from the time Beit HaMikdash HaShani started, and in the time of Beit HaMikdash HaRishon, what happened then? After Sukkot, till Kafei Bekislev, did people bring Bikurim or not? Did they say Mikra Bikurim or they didn't? This Mishnah is it's very strange. How can you bring into Bikurim, which is something from the Torah, you depend on Chanukah, which is much, much, much later. So there are a few answers to this specific question. The main answer is that Sukkot is the end, the time that you collect your produce, and that is the time of Dagan and Tirosh. Dagan, the five grains, and Tirosh, wine. But Yitzhar, olive oil, is the time in Israel, it's the time after Sukkot. Cheshvan, Kislev, these are the times that you harvest the olives and make oil. And whoever drives, especially in the Shomron, even today, you can see the Arabs in this time taking down the olives and making oil. So the machloket is can you bring Bikurim also in the time, the later time that most of the fruits, vegetables, are already finished, only you have the olives, and that's a machloket between Rabbi Yehuda ben Beterah and Tana Kama, but both agree that you can bring Bikurim, and all Bikurim, not only olives. the Sfat Emet learned something from him. The Sfat Emet, Chanukah 5, 6, and 4, the year 1884, says as follows. Remez b'mishnah michag v'ad Chanukah v'fi v'eno koreh. The Mishnah hints about the light of Sukkot. Lirmoz ki nimshach he'arat ha'chag ad Chanukah. Sukkot somehow extends till Chanukah. Ulefi ze nireh ki ha'itchadshut ha'shana shebetishrei nimshach ad atav v'lachem mevi'ot bikurim. She'od hazman michnat neshit ha'shana. The light of Chanukah continues until Chanukah, and somehow the beginning of the year that started on Tishrei, Sukkot, extends, continues till Chanukah. It's Reshit Hashana till Chanukah, not only till Sukkot. That's why one can still bring Bikurim until Chanukah. ולכן נקרא Chanukah, שאתה נגמר החינוך וההתחדשות של השנה. It's called Chanukah because now is the time that the renewal of Chanukah, the renewal of the year, the Hitchatshut, ends on Chanukah. That's why you can bring Bikurim till Chanukah. That's what the Sfat Emet says. I want to see now the Sefer Chashmonaim or Sefer Makkabim. What he tells us about Yehuda HaMaccabi and his people coming into Beit HaMikdash. We all know, I think, the version of Al HaNisim, the version of the Gemara that we said yesterday, that we said a few minutes ago from the Gemara in Shabbat. But in Sefer Chashmonaim, we see something much more interesting. They got up in the morning of the 25th day of the ninth of Kislev, the month of Kislev. 164 BCE, that's my translation. Their way of counting years then was different, but this is the year we're talking about. We're talking about the Yehuda HaMaccabi and his people, and brought a sacrifice, Korban. In the same day, on the same day that the Goyim defiled the Beit HaMikdash, on this very same day, they celebrated with songs, harps, violins, and symbols. The altar was dedicated over 8 days. What do you mean the same day? 25 of Kislev, Sefer Chashmonaim tells us, it's the same day that a few years before the Greeks came into Beit HaMikdash and made it Tameh. Maybe even I would say that's why Yehuda wanted to choose exactly the same day, because it was a symbolic day. Maybe even he chose 25 of Kislev because everybody knew that 3 years before the Goyim, the Greeks, came into Beit HaMikdash that day. That's why Yehuda HaMaccabi chose that date. And the first chapter of Maccabim Aleph, it says it specifically. On the 15th day of Kislev, 167 years BCE, meaning 3 years before what we just read, they build, the Greeks, they build an abomination, shikuts, on the altar. In the cities of Yehuda all around, they built high places, bamot, for sacrifice for other gods. And on the 25th day of the month, they brought sacrifices on the altar in Yerushalayim. Kaf Hei Bekislev, they brought a korban, a sacrifice for the Greek gods in Yerushalayim. That's why Yehuda HaMaccabi chose that date. But why did the Greeks choose the day of Kaf Hei Bekislev? You can say, what do you mean? That's the day they came in. Okay. I want to give you an explanation written, I think the first one was Rabbi Yoel Binun from Michlaet Herzog, Yeshivat Har Etzion. He wrote on it a long article, and he says he found it in the Mor V'Ktzia, one of the Perushim, and he says that it's connected to the book of Haggai. Chagai is one of the 12 small prophets, Tre'asar, at the end of the Nevi'im. And Chagai is one of the three short prophets, the three last one, Chagai, Chayan, Malachi, that are talking about the end of the Bible, meaning the second temple. Nevi'ei Bayit Sheni, the Nevi'im in the second temple, are Chagai, Zechariah, and Malachi. Chagai is a short book, two chapters only, talking, and he covers a time period of less than a month, less than a year, I'm sorry, about 4 months, very short. And Chagai is in a time in Yehuda that 15 years before Koresh allowed the Jews to start building the temple. And we know from the book of Ezra that they came to Ezra, they started collecting the materials, they built the Mizbeach, and then they stopped. Something happened, and the work stopped. And probably because of the nations around us that went to Koresh and told them the Jews want to rebel against you, etc. And it was stopped for about 15 years. Koresh and then Achashverosh, probably. And then Dariavish. And the second year of Dariavish was better for the Jews. But still, the Jews didn't do anything. Because Koresh said to stop the work, probably Achashverosh as well. And the Jews didn't do anything. And Hashem sends Chagai to Am Yisrael and tell them, now is the time. Now is the time to build Beit HaMikdash. Next. In the second year of Dariavish, the king, in the sixth month, on the first day of the month, meaning Aleph Elul, the word of the Lord came by Chagai the prophet to Zerubbabel, the son of Shealtiel, governor of Yehuda, and the Yeshua son of Yehotzadak, the high priest, say, speaks the Lord of hosts. Hashem Tzvakot. Saying, this people say, the time has not come. The time that the Lord's house should be built. It's not time. People are saying, not now. When? We don't know. It's not the time now. Then Hashem Tzvakot came to Chagai the prophet saying, I'm here a number, Pasuk Dalet. Is it time for you yourself to dwell in your well-tempered houses while this house lies waste? You all are sitting in your houses. What about my house? Hashem asks. Now, therefore, this says the Lord of hosts, consider your ways. Look what's happening. You have sown much, but bring in little. You eat, but you have not enough. You drink, but you are not filled with drink. You clothe yourselves, but no one is warm. And he that earns wages to put them into a bag with holes. You have a difficult time. There's not enough food. There's not enough water. You don't earn enough. Why is that? Hashem tells Chagai to tell the Jewish people, because you're not building my house. Beit HaMikdash. Go up to the mountain. We're in Pasuk 8, and bring wood and build the house, and I will take pleasure in it, and I will be glorified, says the Lord. You looked for much, and lo, it came to little. And when you brought it home, I did blow upon it. Why, says the Lord? Because of my house that lies waste, and every one of you runs on his own house. It's time now to stop thinking about yourselves and to start to build Beit HaMikdash. Now, part of the reason they didn't build till now, they were afraid of Dariavish, of the king. And basically what Chagai tells them, don't be afraid. You build, and the Ezrat Hashem will get permission afterwards. Always when I read this chapter, I think of the Mityashvim in Yehuda Shomron, and that many times they said, we don't have permission, 100% build now, and afterwards we'll get permission. It's important for Am Yisrael to build the temple because they decided, not only because the king allowed them. There is something by doing it, taking responsibility, taking a risk, and building it. Jumping in the water and building it, afterwards you'll get permission. But the first step should be dependent on you, not only about on Koresh. Afterwards, we see that the people do, Am Yisrael, do what Haggai says, and they start collecting all the materials, and they're preparing a few other nevuot. And then the last nevuah is on a very interesting date. And that we're in chapter, second chapter, Pasuk Yud-Ten. On the 24th day of the ninth month, in the second year of Daryavesh, the word of the Lord came by Haggai, the prophet, saying, when are we talking about? 24 of the ninth month, meaning Kaf Daled, 24 of Kislev. And he says, and now I pray you consider from this day onwards, before a stone was laid upon a stone in the temple of the Lord. But now consider from this day onwards, from the 24th day of the ninth month, from the day that the foundation of the Lord's temple was laid, consider it. Is the seed yet in the barn, and the vine and the fig tree and the pomegranate and the olive tree is still not bring forth? From this day, I will bless you. Now you are starting to build. From this day, you will be blessed. There will be no hunger. The trees, the fruit will have good quantity, good quality, and and now that you're deciding that you build the foundation of the temple, now I will bless you. So when was it? When was the beginning of the Chanukat Beit Sheni, the dedication, the foundation, not Chanukah, but beginning of the building was, looks like, a day after this nevuah that Am Yisrael did it. When is that? Kaf Hei Bekislev. Meaning that 25 of Kislev was the day that Beit HaMikdash HaShani was the day that they started building. Could be, it's not clear 100%, but it's very logic to say that the Greeks knew that Kaf Hei Bekislev was an important day for the Jews. When the Greeks went into Beit HaMikdash and made it Tameh, they chose a very important day then for the Jews. 25 of Kislev, they knew that for the Jews it's an important day. Ah, the Greeks said, you thought 25 of Kislev, you started building Beit HaMikdash. We will show you what we will do on the same day. We will destroy it, not destroy it physically, but spiritually destroy it. And that's why Yehuda HaMaccabi, years afterwards, show that day to show them, you thought you're smarter than us. In Hebrew we say, tzochek mi shetzochek acharon. You laugh at us, now see, we will laugh at you. We will bring back a fevek Islam to its original status of puring, beginning, making Beit HaMikdash pure and strong and Jewish. Let's say. Just a second, I have to. Sorry, that was my wife. Okay. Can we see a trace of Chanukah even in the Torah? Is there any anything that happened in the Torah that we can somehow connect it to Chanukah? The pshat is, no. 25 of Kislev is not mentioned in the Torah in any date, but still we do have something. What we read in Chanukah, the Kriya Torah, is Chanukat HaMishkan in Parashat Naso, Bamidbar Perek Zayin, 7th chapter, the 12 Nesi'in bringing their Korbanot. That's what we read in Chanukah. Each day of the seven first days, we read the Chanukah of the first, second, third Nasi, etc., to the seventh. And the eighth day, we read from the eighth till the 12th, we read five Nesi'in, the Korbanot, and Chanukat HaMishkan, and as well the summarized. And according to some opinions, we read also the next chapter, another four psukim of the next chapter, which is the menorah. The beginning of Parashat Baalotcha, Hashem spoke to Moshe, speak to Aharon and say to him, when you light the lamps, Baalotcha et hanerot, el mul pnei menorah, ya'iru shivat hanerot. When you light the lamps, the seven lamps shall give light towards the body of the candlestick. Vayas ken Aharon, el mul pnei menorah, elan nerotea, kasher tzivah Hashem et Moshe. Aaron did so. He lighted its lamps over against the body of the candlestick, as the Lord commanded Moshe. V'zeh ma'aseh menorah mikshah zahav adlichah mikshahi, kamrei asher ra'ah shel Moshe, ki aseh Aaron. Okay, that's Moshe. Rashi asks, why does the tzivui Hashem, is this parashia here? Why is it right after Parashat HaNesi'im? And Rashi's words, Lama nismecha Parashat HaMenorah leParashat HaNesi'im? We have smichut parashiot, it's one after the other. Why? So Rashi brings the Midrash, a famous Midrash, that when Aharon saw the Chanukah of the Nesi'im, he was distressed, he was upset. Why? Because the 12 Nesi'im, they didn't have somebody from Shevet Levi, from Aharon's tribe. They had Ephraim and Menashe, as they have the 12. But Aharon didn't have, Levi didn't have, and Aharon was upset. Not, he wasn't there. So God told him, Amar lo HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Chayecha shelcha gdola mishelahem she'ata madlik umeitim et hanerot. Your share is bigger than theirs, than the Nesi'im. Why? Because you light the candles, the menorah. So the pshat is, what usually we explain, they brought a sacrifice once, and you, Aharon, are lighting the menorah every day. That's much bigger than theirs. But the Ramban asks, just a second, לא נתברר לי למה נחמו בהדלקת הנרות ולא נחמו בכתורת בוקר וערב ובכל הקורבנות. Why he said, Aaron, why this, what God told them he can be happy with was the candles and not the ktoret every morning, every evening. Why not the korbanot? It's the Kohen HaGadol. Why the candles? So the Ramban says, the candles, the menorah here, is a remez for lighting the menorah, lighting the candles, the chanukiah, by Aharon and his uvanav, meaning the chashmonaim, in the second temple. And he brings a midrash, he saw it Megillat Zim Rabbi Nissim, that Hashem told Moshe, a different version of the same midrash, that Hashem told Aharon, what will be yours that will be greater than theirs? Yesh Chanukah acheret sheyesh Chanukah acheret sheyesh ba'adlakat nerot. Ve'ani oseh al Yisrael al yedei banecha nisim u'tshu'ah. Ve'chanukah shekruya al shmah, v'hi chanukat bnecha shmonai. Lefichach hizmich parashat el parashat chanukat nerot ad kan lishonot. You are upset, Aharon, that in the Chanukah of the Mishkan, you and your tribe didn't get a share? So I will pay you in a different Chanukah, and it will even be named on your descendants, Chanukah Bnei Chashmonai, and yours is bigger than theirs. Why? So the Rabbah said at the end, because Beit HaMikdash, the Korbanot of the Nesi'im are connected to the Mishkan, to Beit HaMikdash. But when Beit HaMikdash is destroyed, there are no Korbanot. But for you, Aharon, and your tribe, I'm giving the Hadlakat Nerot of Chanukah, Chanukat Chashmonai. And that will be even after Churban Beit HaMikdash. So yours, Aharon, and your tribe is bigger than all other 12 tribes. So don't be sad, Aharon. That's what the Ramban says, connecting the story of Chanukat HaMishkan to the story of Chanukah. But the Yalkut Shimoni is even more specific. The Yalkut Shimoni says that Amar Rabbi Chanina, Bekafei Bekislev, Nigmar Melechet HaMishkan. Ve'asa Mekupal Ad Echad Benisan. Rabbi Chanina says, the work on the Mishkan, building the Mishkan, was completed in 25 of Kislev. They started building the Mishkan, and the day they finished was 25 of Kislev. But it went into use only the first day of Nisan. Chanukah, the Mishkan was only a bit more than 3 months later, and Aleph Nisan. As it says, Be'er Chodesh HaRishon, Be'echad LaChodesh, Takim Et HaMishkan. And then the Jews were saying, hey, והיו ישראל ממלמלים אל משה, לומר, למה לא הוקם יד? The Jews is always, we're always suspicious, we always have rumors. Why did משה do the חנוכת המשכן and כך חי בכסלב? That was the day that המשכן, well, we finished building, that's it, let's start using it. And Am Yisrael didn't understand this. Shema Dofi Rabo, there's a problem with it, the Mishkan, and this date maybe, it's not a good date, so we won't want to build, what? V'akadosh Baruch Hu chashav le'arev simchat ha-Mishkan v'chodesh ha-Nolad Bo Yitzchak. Hashem wanted to do the Chanukat ha-Mishkan and the month that Yitzchak was born. According to Chazal, he was born on Nisan, so Hashem wanted to combine the two. Why exactly wanted to combine the two? What's the connection between them? It's a good question, but let's leave that. Hashem wanted postpone it to Nisan. Umeata efsid Kislev shenigmera bo amlacha. So Kislev is upset now at the month. So Amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu, alai leshalem. I have to pay him to give him some form of compensation to Kislev. So what did God pay him? Chanukat. Chashmonai, that the Chanukah, our Chanukah of the Chashmonaim was on Kafhei Bekislev. So the Yalkut Shimoni tells us that Kafhei Bekislev was a date that probably was known from the Mishkan. Kafhei Bekislev was the Mishkan was finished. They didn't start using it, but it was a date they finished. Maybe even that's why the people in Haggai wanted the beginning, the Chanukah of beginning of the building, exactly Chanukah, of Beit Sheni, of Beit HaMikdash Sheni, to be on Kafhei Bekislev, somehow to keep on the date. And that's why afterwards the Yevanim did it because of what we saw in Haggai, and Yehuda HaMaccabi did it by Chanukat Beit Chashmonai. Meaning, I'm giving an explanation to the Yalkut Shimoni that Chanukat Chashmonai, it's not like something, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Shilem, that it happened, you know, happened accidentally that the Chashmonaim came. Because of this date, was an important date, that's why they chose Kafhei Bekislev, starting from Chanukat HaMishkan. Okay. Now, I want to bring maybe Chanukah's roots is earlier than the Mishkan. Maybe Chanukah's roots is already from the beginning, from the creation of the world, from Mamash, the first months of the creation, from Adam Rishon. And this is the Gemara in Avodah Zarah that talks about Adam Rishon. The Mishnah there says, Ve'elu ideihem shel ovdei kochavim, gives us the chagim of ovdei kochavim, kalenda ve'stara nura ve'kartisim v'yom ginus ha'shem lachim v'yom ha'leida, etc. Kalenda, of course, connected to calendar. Star nura, star, no, the star is nura in Aramaic is esh, the light, the fire, the star fire, the light fire. That was the name of a chag for of the kochavim, and we know according to halacha that on days of Avodah Zarah you're not supposed to sell the goyim or to buy from them because they will thank the gods, and sometimes even 3 days before you're not supposed to sell to them. According to most Ashkenazi poskim, at least, this doesn't employ today to the Christians and Muslims, only to Mashu of the Avodah Zarah. So these are the chagim. The Gemara says, it's not translated, Amar Chanan bar Rava, kalenda, chet yamim achar tkufa. The chag, their chag, is 8 days after the tkufa. Rashi says, tkufa tevet, v'hayu osim chet yamim retzufim id. Tkufa tevet is the day of the year that the nights are the longest and the days are the shortest. Today is 21st or 22nd of December. In those times, it was the 25th of December, meaning the Roman times, and Rashi says this Chag calendar is 8 days after Tkufat Tevet. Meaning they had a holiday 8 days from Tkufat Tevet, from the day of Tkufat Tevet that until the day of Tkufat Tevet, the days become shorter and shorter, and the night longer, and from the day of Tkufat Tevet, the days become longer and the nights become shorter. So Tkufat Tevet is the day of the year that the night is the longest. In Israel, it's about 14 hours of dark and 10 hours of light. About, of course, when we go to Europe and northern countries, so you have more. And if you go to Sweden and Scandinavia and all those places, so you barely have light. So this is calendar, 8 days after Tkufat Tevet. Star Nura. Shchet yamim lifnei tkufa. Starnura is 8 days before tkufa tevet. So we have a chag, ver chag, starnura, 8 days before tkufa tevet. And we have calendar, which is 8 days from tkufa tevet, according to Rashi, it runs for 8 days. Tanu Rabbanan. Lefi shera Adam Rishon, yom shemitvaet veolech. Adam, the first man, noticed that every day the sun went down a bit earlier than the day before. Rashi says, from Tishrei to Tevet, he sees that the days are becoming shorter. We are talking, of course, after Chet Adam Rishon. Adam Rishon sinned, and suddenly he sees that every day he has less light, and it becomes colder. And the trees and all the green starts to shrivel, you know, it's you don't have produce so much, and the trees, all the leaves fall down, the world changes. The English. So who is me, he moaned, because I sin. The world gets darker every day and evidently will be destroyed. This is my punishment. the Hebrew, Ha'olam chozer le'tohu v'vohu. We're going back to tohu v'vohu. I was just created, I sinned, and now my punishment is that God is going to destroy the world. Adam HaShon understood that if there will be no light and no sun, so you can't live. You can't live. So what did he do? So he decided to fast and pray to God for 8 days. Amad v'yashav chet yamin b'ta'anit u'v'tfila. And after 8 days, something happened. What happened? He got the tkufat evet. And then the days began to lengthen, and then he said, this is the way of the world. He got the 8 days till tkufat evet. And the next day he sees there's a bit more light. The sun is now, the sun is setting a bit later. And only then he understands, that's minhag ha'olam, that's the circle of the year. The days become shorter until you get to the peak point, and then they become longer. I don't know if he understood all the astronomy, but that basic fact he understood. It's minhag ha'olam. But minhag ha'olam, what do you do with it? So he celebrated for 8 days. Halach ve'asa shmona yamim tovim. Now, from the day of Tkufat Evet, he celebrated 8 days. From the next year and on, he celebrated 8 days before and 8 days after. Lashana ha'acheret asan la'elu ve'la'elu yamim tovim. So, the 8 days after and the 8 days before, probably. Some people say, no, the 8 days after and only the first day, first of the 8 days before. Or maybe even he did only 2 days, the eighth day before and the eighth day after. It's not so clear here. But he did it. He did this Yamim Tovim. Adam HaRishon. He, Adam, dedicated these days for God. And they, the idol worshippers, celebrated for the idols. Who kva'am l'shem shamayim v'hem kva'um l'shem avodat kochavim. So this calendar and starnura is days that the avodat zara took from Adam HaRishon, but originally Adam HaRishon did them l'shem shamayim. To God. To thank God. To praise God. And they took these dates and they used it for Avodah Zarah. Now, we all know, I think, that the Jews are not the only ones that are celebrating a holiday connected to light and happiness in these dark times of the year. Chanukah is always around Tkufat Tevet, a few weeks before, a few weeks after, around Tkufat Tevet. And I think the Gemara understood that. The Gemara understood that we are not the only ones, celebrating Chanukah. Now, here the Gemara doesn't talk about Chanukah, but it talks about 8 days. It talks about, we said the Star Anura, the light of fire. We talked about praising God for 8 days around the time of the darkest times of the year, physically meaning the days are the shortest and the night is the longest. And even the date, 25, we know, as I said, that in the Roman times, till I don't remember what year exactly they shifted the calendar, but in the ancient times, the Tkufa was on the 25th of December of their month, but the 25th. And our Chanukah, we know, is 25. Is it only a coincidence? I think it's very difficult to say. Now, what most people say, most chokrim researchers said, we Jews, and you know, the Muslims, the Christians, and other, we took it from the Avodah Zarah. It was a holiday for the Chag then, connecting to raising light in the darkest times, and we just took it from them. But the Gemara here, I think, says, no, you misunderstood. The original Chanukah, the foundation of Chanukah, the earliest root of Chanukah is from Adam HaRishon. Adam HaRishon looked at the world and wanted to praise Hashem for 8 days. He was the one that started it, L'Shem Shamayim. Afterwards, of Avodah Zarah took it and made it what they made from it, okay. But our Chanukah doesn't go back to the Avodah Zarah, goes back to Adam HaRishon. Maybe even why do I think Chanukah is connected to here? Because look, let's see if we can see it here. Look, we see here in the Gemara Avodah Zarah, it says, Halach ve'asa shmona yamim tovim. And by us, it says, Vedliku mimeno shmona yamim. Similar words. Leshana ha'acheret asa'an la'elu ve'lenu yamim tovim. And here, leshana acheret kva'um va'asa'um. Here, yamim tovim. And here, yamim tovim. Meaning, the Gemara wants to tell us, look, it's connected. It's connected. This Chanukah, the roots of Chanukah are from Adam HaRishon already. And we have something interesting. Beit HaMikdash was built as a Mikdash to God. And then Avodah Zarah made it impure. And then it was pured again by the Jews, by the Chashmonaim, by the Maccabim. Chag Chanukah is similar. Chanukah was established as a Chag for praising Hashem. Afterwards, it became Chol, it became Tameh by the Avodah Zarah. And then it was redeemed and became Tahor again by the Jews. Chanukah and Beit HaMikdash have a similar three steps. So Chanukah comes to sanctify this meaning of light, turning on light in the darkest times, which could be even a message that other nations can copy. Can have the same. Maybe this message not only a Jewish message, but we take this message and connect it to God, and not disconnect it to God and talk only about our light. We talk about our light, lighting it in the spirit, because the spirit of God, of Beit HaMikdash, of Judaism. So that's why Chanukah, if Chag Midrabanan, yes, doesn't have the halachot of Chag Midrabanan Torah. But it is, its roots are already, as we said, from Adam HaRishon, Chanukat HaMishkan. We saw the Yalkut Shimoni that the Mishkan was dedicated, was finished on Kafei Bekislev. And then we said Chagai, beginning of building the second temple on Kafei Bekislev. And then the Yevanim coming to Beit HaMikdash and destroying it. And Kafei Bekislev, and then Yehuda HaMaccabi doing Kafei Bekislev, Chanukah, cleaning the temple, lighting the menorah, and from that day on, now it's already a Chag Midrabanan that we celebrate every year. Any questions? Questions till now before we keep on? Okay, so I want to talk To add something, we have exactly 15 minutes, okay? The connection between Chanukah and Sukkot. We saw at the beginning, that bringing Bikurim can extend till Chanukah, and we brought the Sfat Emet, that the light, the He'ara of Sukkot keeps on till Chanukah, and we said there that the time when you want to harvest, when you bring in your produce, the Ganti Rosh V'Yitzhar, so this is the time of the olives, of the Yitzhar, and this is somehow that the end of the year somehow extends not only Tishrei, Rosh Hashanah, Sukkot, but it extends till Chanukah. Now, I want to show the connection between Chanukah and Sukkot in a few other places. Just a second, let's share it again. Okay. Chanukah and Sukkot. The book of Chashmonaim Beit, says as follows. On the day in which the Nochrim defiled the Mikdash, on that very day, the Mikdash was purified on the 25th day of Kislev. That we already saw in Sefer Chashmonaim 1. They celebrated the 8 days of Chanukah with great happiness, like the festival of Sukkot. They had 8 days of Chanukah, just like 8 days of Sukkot, we know, but they celebrated it just like the festival of Sukkot. What does it mean? As they recalled how they had suffered on Sukkot during the war, when they were forced to hide out on mountains and in caves like animals. Therefore, they now took branches and palm fronds in their hands and gave thanks to Hashem that they were able to purify God's Mikdash. Meaning, on the first Chanukah, on Kafei de Kislev, 164 BCE, they celebrated Chanukah with elements from Sukkot. Anaf etzavot, anfe hadar, kapot tmarim, palm trees, hadas, anfe hadar, maybe it talks about etrogim, meaning they somehow Chanukah was because they could not celebrate Sukkot properly, they celebrated Chanukah in a similar way. Meaning Chanukah is somehow a reflection, I would say, of Sukkot. Even, I didn't bring it here, but in the Vayikra, chapter 23, is the chapter talks about the Mo'adot. The last Chag is talked about is Chag HaSukkot. And the next parashat that the Torah brings is Tzaved Bnei Yisrael v'ikru elecha shemen zayit zach katit lamaor le'alot le'tamid. Right after the Torah mentions Sukkot, it mentions olive oil and adlakat hanerot. And why? Because to tell us there is a strong connection between the two. Where else we see a connection between Sukkot and Chanukah? So the Gemara says, according to Beit Shammai thinks that pochet veholech, the first day you light 8 candles, and each day you have one less, until the last day we have one. Today, according to Beit Hillel, that Mosif Beholech, the first day one, and each day we add another one. But when Beit Shammai says, why do we Pochet Beholech, why do we start with 8 and go down? And one of the reasons mentioned there is Keneged Parei HaChag Shel Sukkot, just like the Parim, the bulls of Sukkot, of Korban Musaf, that we start with 13 on the first day, the second day 12, 11, 10, etc., until the last day is 7. So just like Parei HaChag are going down, Pochet Veolech, so similar to the candles of Chanukah. Meaning, Beit Shammai wants to tell us, Chanukah is strongly connected again to Sukkot. The Sfat Emet tries to explain to us what is this connection. So he says that Chanukah, three festivals appear in the Torah, and three additional festivals are rabbinic festivals rooted in the oral Torah, Torah Shebe'al Peh. The rabbinic festivals get their strength from the Torah, like the moon gets its light from the sun. The moon gets light from the sun. The Chagim Nidei Rabbanan get their strength, their He'ara, their light, from the Chagim of the Torah. So we have Shloshet Hargalim, Pesach, Shavuot, and Sukkot, and we have two Chagim Nidei Rabbanan, Chanukah and Purim, and each Chag Nidei Rabbanan is connected, gets its strength from one of the regalim. So let's think, which one, Chanukah and Purim, which one they will get their strength from. So, Chanukah reflects the light of Sukkot. Purim, the light of Shavuot. Purim and Shavuot. Shavuot is Chag Matan Torah. We know Purim, what the Midrash says, Hadur kiblu avimei HaChashverosh, that some of the giving again the Torah was the time of Purim, that Am Yisrael wanted to be Jews, wanted to accept the Torah, not like Shavuot, that it was somehow forced. And then, so Purim is somehow connected to Shavuot, Chanukah is connected to Sukkot, as we gave explanations before, and we have a problem. What about Pesach? And that leaves only Pesach without the counterpart. There's no, what is the Chag Nidei Rabbanan of Pesach? It's very nice, Sfat Emet, to say we have three Chagim from the Torah, but only two Chagim Nidei Rabbanan. So there's not a strong connection. So Sfat Emet says, we hope that one day Pesach will have a counterpart of its own. As it says in the Torah, I will once again show you wonders, wondrous things like the days of the Exodus from Egypt. I think it's the book of Tzfania. And if you ask me, this could be a shiur for Yom HaTzmaut, I think that we can definitely say that Yom HaTzmaut is very similar to Pesach. Pesach, we had a Geula, Me'avdut L'Chirut, Yom HaTzmaut as well. And the other connections. So these are the three Chagim Midei Rabbanan connected to the three Chagim Mideoraita. This could be maybe an answer for a very famous question about the 8 days of Chanukah. The question that the Beit Yosef brings, what's called in the yeshivish world, Kushiyata Beit Yosef, why do we have 8 days of Chanukah and not seven? What do you mean? The miracle that happened with Nes Pach Hashem, with the olive oil that we found in Beit HaMikdash, was only 7 days. Because it was supposed to be enough for 1 day, and then it was enough for 8 days. So the miracle that Hashem did, that it was enough for extra 7 days. So Chanukah should be only 7 days. Not 8 days. The first day wasn't a miracle. The first day they found enough olive oil for 1 day. That's not a miracle. That's a famous kushya of Beit Yosef, and I saw a booklet of 101 answers to this kushya of the Beit Yosef. 101 different answers why Chanukah is 8 days and not seven, even though it should have been maybe 7 days. There are many, many, many answers to this. The main answer, I think, that two main answers. One is that even finding the olive oil had only 1 day worth in it, but finding it was a miracle because the Yevanim tried to touch everything, that everything will be coming. Finding the one was a nes. That's the first day. And then the second miracle was the extra 7 days. According to the Meshech Chochmah, you can say that the first day was the nest of the Nitzachon, the Milchama, the war against the Greeks, and that Hashem gave in the Maccabean spirits the courage to fight against them and to win and to come into Beit HaMikdash and then to find the olive oil, the oil. That's the first day. And then the other seven. But we think that maybe because of what we just said, Chazal wanted 8 days because the connection to Sukkot, and because eight, we know many Mefarshim talk about that seven and eight. Seven is the natural sphera, I would say, and eight is the unnatural, above natural. That's why we have 7 days of the week. That the natural system, maybe Yovel, but we have Brit Milah comes after the first 7 days and the eighth day. We have Shivat Yemei Miluim, and then the dedication was on the eighth day, that is after the 7 days. And we have Shmini Atzeret that comes after the 7 days of Sukkot. So Sukkot is 7 days, but the eighth day is different. So maybe the Maccabim wanted to teach us that Chanukah is the 8 days and not seven, even though maybe you should have seven. Yes, but seven is a natural world. We want the eighth day to remind us that Hashem is here as well. The miracles of Hashem that helps us to break the natural circles and to add on it another higher step of the above natural of the Eloki, the godly a part of this holiday, which is the eighth day. That's why some people treat the last day of Chanukah as special. Similar to Shmini Atzeret, that is a bit different than the other 7 days of Sukkot. Some people see Zot Chanukah, the eighth day of Chanukah, as special. First of all, we know that when we read the Torah, the eighth day, whoever is laning, a Baal Kore knows that for the first 7 days, he doesn't have to prepare a lot. The first day, maybe a bit longer, but from the second to the second, the seventh day, the Kriyat Torah is very short, only the Nasi of that day. But in Zot Chanukah, the eighth day, we read from the eighth till the end of the 12 Nasiim, plus the summarize of everything, plus what I said at the beginning, Be'alotcha et HaNerot. So Zot Chanukah, it's a longer Kriyat Torah. There is a minhag, I don't know anyone that does it today, but there is a minhag mentioned in the Poskim, of not doing melacha by women or even by men on the first and eighth day. We know the minhag of women not doing melacha when the candles are lit, at least the first half hour. But there's another minhag mentioned, the first and eighth day. First day, we understand why. Eighth day, maybe because of Zot Chanukah, maybe that's the addition that the Maccabim wanted to add. And that's why it's a special day that we don't do melacha. That's the Maharil brings this. The Sfat Emet, no, the Gra, sorry. The Gra says the 8 days of Chanukah, we say Halel Shalem. And it's against the 8 days during the year that we don't say Halel Shalem, which is 1 day of Rosh Hashanah, 1 day of Yom Kippur, and the six last days of Chol HaMoed Pesach and Shvi'i Shel Pesach, that we say only Chatzi Halel, not Halel Shalem. So the 8 days of Chanukah are equivalent to the 8 days of the other Chagim. And he says that the last day of Chanukah is Keneged Yom HaKippurim. And he says that the eighth day of Chanukah has some sort of Sgula, similar to Yom HaKippurim, day of Mechila, of Atonement, of the day of the Chotam, the last day. So Chanukah is somewhat, Zot Chanukah is somehow has a Sgula of Sgula similar to Yom HaKippurim. That's what the Gra brings. And there's the Bnei Sachar said that the last days of Chanukah mesugal lepkidat acharim ve'acharot for to people that don't have babies, so they can. This is a day of segula of Bezrat Hashem having getting in herayon and having babies. And I think again, as I said, it all comes from the connection between Sukkot and Chanukah. If there are no questions, so I'll thank you very much and wish you a Chanukah Sameach. Yes.
Yeah, okay. So with regard to this connection between Chanukah and Sukkot, which seems to be a natural connection because Sukkot has this universal element to it, all of the sacrifices, the korbanot for the amamim, and going back to Adam HaRishon, it's obviously a very universal thing. So why don't we have minhagim on Chanukah that represent or that replicate these minhagim that they did, that's listed here in the book of Maccabim with branches and palms? Why don't we therefore on Chanukah not only have the menorah, but we have some of the symbols of Sukkot? It seems that we should.
Good question. Maybe because I thought you'll ask something else, meaning Sukkot, it's a chag, a universal holiday, and Chanukah somehow is universal as well.
Correct.
In some aspect, it's only Jewish. Yehuda HaMaccabi was against the Yevanim, etc. It's very much inside Am Yisrael, but this time, and it has something in it which is very universal, as I said, that other nations have similar things. But to answer your question, why don't we see more elements? I don't know, we don't see many elements of Purim connected to Shavuot. There's some connections, yes, but I don't think we have to do what the Maccabim did, that mamash to take the Arba Minim and to do it on Chanukah. Each one is unique. We don't have to copy. We have one Sukkot. We don't need another Sukkot. We see the connection and we can understand better Chanukah, but I don't think it's too easy to take the Arba Minim and to put it on Chanukah. It's too easy. Okay, but it's a good question. I don't have a good answer to this good question. Chanukah Sameach, and thank you. Thank you very much, everyone.
Okay, Yasher Koach, interesting shiur.
When do we get together next? What time?
It's 10:30.
Great class, Rabbi. Thank you so much.
Yasher Koach.
I learned a lot. There was a lot I never, ever had heard before. So it was really great. Really, really enjoyed it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Chagurim Sameach.
Right, the next class is supposed to start at 10:45.
10:30.
I'm sorry, 10:30, right? The first class is from 9 till 10:15. The second class is supposed to start at 10:30. So in 15 minutes, there should be the next class.
So
you can see why I wanted you to specify the time.
Yeah.
You should keep the Zoom session open. Last week, it got closed it. So just keep it open.
Yeah, that was a mistake. In general, the Zoom will just be left open.
Keep it open.
But I could close mine and come back, right? Okay.
Yeah, you can just go to the same link again.
You can.
Okay, thanks.